Okay, number two, we're asked to find the points of intersection of these two curves in polar coordinates. So the first thing you want to do is make a rough sketch to see how many intersection points to expect. So r equals 2, well, r is 2, theta can be whatever it wants. So that's going to be a circle centered at the origin with a radius of 2. So that's r equals 2. What about the other guy? R equals 4 cosine 2 theta. That's going to be another one of those roses. And you go through the usual procedure and find out how that graphs. It's going to come in like this, come around, like so. All right. So we've got I forgot to finish it off here. Comes in this way. So we've got 2, 4, 6, 8 intersection points. All right, so how do we find the intersection of polar curves? Well, we've got r equals f of theta, and then r equals g of theta. And so the first thing we try to do is we look for at the poles, or origin, because the intersections, the pole and the origin, are they going to intersect there? No. The red curve goes through the origin several times as we trace it up, but the blue curve never does, so there's none of those. Okay, so that's usually the first thing we do. The second thing we do is we set the functions of theta actually just equal to each other and see what we get out of that. So in this case, I set 2 equal to 4 cosine 2 theta. And so that means I get cosine of 2 theta is 1/2, which means 2 theta is either pi over 3 plus some multiple of 2 pi, or it's 5 pi rather over 3 plus some multiple of 2 pi. So that gives me theta is pi over 6 plus some multiple of pi, or theta is 5 pi over 6 plus some multiple of pi. Now, as you go through and plug these into the r values, okay, what you'll find is this family of solutions is going to give us this point, this point, and that point. All right, so as I run through all the values of k, I'm going to pick up just those 4 points, which means there's 4 points I still don't have. All right, so we look for intersections at the pole. If we don't have any there, we move on and do this. The other thing is you replace r with the opposite of r and theta with theta plus pi in one of the equations. Now, why are we doing this again? Well, we know that polar coordinates are a bit tricky. If I have a polar point r theta, I could actually get to that same point by having the opposite of r, but just adjusting the theta by pi. So as I look at these examples, it doesn't matter which one I pick. I'm going to do this one. I'm going to replace r with negative r and theta with theta plus pi. Well, there's no theta to replace, so I just end up replacing r with negative r. So now I got negative 2. R is negative 2. And then I keep this one the same. So you do the replacement on just one of them. So now I get this equation. I get 4 cosine 2 theta is negative 2. So cosine of 2 theta is negative 1/2. And so that means that 2 theta is either 2 pi over 3 plus 2 pi k, or 2 theta is 4 pi over 3 plus 2 pi k. So out of this, I get theta equals pi over 3 plus pi k, or theta is 2 pi over 3 plus pi k. If you run through those, that's going to get you these other ones. Okay, so what are the points of intersection? So what's my final answer here? Well, I just got to list down these 8 points. So I start with pi over 6. And I plug pi over 6 in to figure out where I am. Well, since they're intersection points, folks, it doesn't matter which of these I plug them into. I'll plug them into that one because I know the r is always 2. So pi over 6, 2, and then 7 pi over 6, 2, then 5 pi over 6, 2. Oops. And then 11 pi over 6, 2. So those are the 4 answers I get out of this one. Now the answers I get out of this one, I'm going to plug these angles in. The r here that makes that work is negative 2. So the other ones will be pi over 3, negative 2, 4 pi over 3, negative 2, 2 pi over 3, negative 2, and 5 pi over 3, negative 2. All right? So those are, what I should really say is these are representations for each of the 8 intersection points. Once again, there are infinitely many ways to describe these points. Okay, but these are the 8 distinct representations for these points. So that'll do it for number 2.